Water supply to Frabe College has been a tall order for over a week now. The college's newly replaced iron reservoir under the Badia project stands empty and starved of water. The college had earlier been privileged to get water supply directly from the Gumma facility at Gloucester, but that privilege seems to have disappeared.
Well, some time back last year, the principal for the college, Vice Chancellor, Professor Kamara, visited my office and indicated that there are issues with the water supply in the campus, and the other students will come on campus. And then this year we went for a meeting at the Bintulani Hotel, where I had discussions with the Minister of Higher Education, and he also raised the same issue. And I told him, I said, we need to visit to see what the issue is like. So we came out here today to really investigate what is the issue that is affecting the, what are the issues affecting water supply in the campus, and so that we can find a solution to that problem.
The assessment tour led onto the college's main treatment plant at Cotwright. The engineers at the plant facility, the existing tanks they have can only take...
The supply of water has been a perennial problem. And even in the past administration, and when I took over, that was one of the major problems I actually identified. You know, and we are very, very determined to actually try to solve that, you know, for good. Last year, about the same time, I invited four or five ministers, Minister of Land, Minister of Interior, Minister of Environment, the then Minister of Education, and the Minister of Resources, and Water Resources. And we were there at the site, and they saw the problem there. And we were all there today, we saw it. It has not improved at all, it's just deteriorated over time. We are determined to solve that, and I think, you know, when they go now, I think this is the second time they are seeing that, and they know it is not a joke. And if particularly at the point where we want to bring students into the hostels, we're talking about more than 1,000 students coming to the hostels.
The college's ancient water storage facility, built in the early 80s, are now obsolete and cannot serve their intended purpose. The campus's main subsidiary dam is at Moiba. Water streams through these Gumma pipes and eventually make its way to the treatment plant. But the infrastructure could only achieve a minimal impact, as most of the water is spilling.
Well, this has a long history. This project was conceived something like 20 years back, 2002, for both university college campuses then. Then you're talking about Jala and Frabe College. Whilst we were able to implement most of it at Jala, the FBC1 failed through, and it was restarted in 2014. So what you're seeing here now is maybe slightly below what you need now at this instant in time. However, the projection then for the water system was for a 35-year package. So we really believe what is on ground at this instant in time can still suffice if we are able to get all the components right.
The effects of deforestation and forest encroachment seems to have taken a toll on the main dam at Gloucester. This dam is the main water catchment facility that is supposed to supply water to the entire Frabe College campus. Most of the waterways have been blocked by farmers who divert the water by digging heaps and connect tiny rubber pipes for watering purposes. But for a campus which will soon begin to attract thousands of students into its hostels, one could only hope that this perennial shortage of water comes to a grinding halt once and for all. SLBC News R, Victor Jones reporting.